Bad idea to book a trip, I swear. Every time, it's always very nerve-wracking to book a trip, especially when you're just deciding to just click and buy the ticket. But as soon as you buy that ticket, as soon as you hit that ticket, it's just always an adventure after that. It's super early. We're in Mexico. We decided to come out to Mexico City, and it's just never—it's never a bad idea to book a trip. I swear.
These people had the custom to make the city several times, and they cover one after another. But when you have something like this grass, it's because of the weather. So the soil came here and covered all this area because it was an abandoned city. The mountain just behind the pyramid of the moon. And you remember when we were there in the first area, we saw the mountain very, very big.
Yeah.
When you get there, inside the plaza of the moon, this is the plaza of the moon. When you enter into the plaza of the moon, into the square, all the mountain is going to disappear.
Really?
Yes, it's going to be covered completely and exactly by the
shape.
Yes. And also, my friend, yes, when you were there, In the pyramid of the moon, try to turn around and you are going to compare the pyramid of the moon with that mountain over there.
Oh, and
they fit each other.
It's up for interpretation.
That is what you said. That is your opinion.
Yes. Oh, okay.
And that is interesting.
Yeah.
Teotihuacan was so big, 150,000 people living in this place, because they were in contact with hundreds of people coming from different places to Teotihuacan. The people today, they are visiting the Basilica Guadalupe.
Yeah.
They are coming from the Mayas area, from different areas. 7 million of people, just one single day.
Really?
Yes, just the 12th of December,
yeah.
All these people, different caravans from different areas, came to the Basilica of Guadalupe. Mm-hmm. Some of them, they are coming from the Mexico. Here in Mexico, we have different countries. We are not the same people.
Mm.
The South people are very different, the North and the West. So all these people, we share the same basic religion.
Mm-hmm.
So the religion, at least in America, was the tradition that contact or made the contact with the ancestors.
Mm.
So the God the God who gave you the right to establish Israel right here or the right to control this place is the same God 300 or 400 years later that you are worshiping in this pyramid. So the same God is giving you the right to control this place, but that right was given for the first people. So you need to always to keep or to transmit this knowledge from the ancestors.
Yes.
But these symbols, when the people were coming here, they could understand, mm-hmm. not reading, but they could understand the symbols, mm-hmm. because all this green area mm-hmm. was sharing the same religion.
So we just mm-hmm. finished the tour with Victor. Victor did an excellent, excellent job of kind of explaining everything. And the question that I asked him that I thought was the most interesting was kind of how did societies develop kingdoms? How did you know if you were a king? How did they develop this class system? And he essentially said that it was based on knowledge. And if you had knowledge of certain, knowledge and control of certain resources, then they saw that as your birthright or your God-given right. And so in order to keep the societal constructs, what they would do is keep the knowledge within the constructs, right? So if you had knowledge of astrology and weather and things like that and were able to understand when and where to grow crops, you would have control over the food. And then, you know, once you have control over food, you know, that's obviously, you know, what a lot of people are going to be, everyone's going to be most interested in. So I just kind of related that to when people tell you that education, especially when you're trying to move through society and climb the classes, you definitely have to have the knowledge. And once you have the knowledge, then you'll have some sort of control over some resources. So I just kind of related, you know, how the societal constructs here at Teotihuacan, I'm killing that name, can relate to kind of what we're all trying to do, you know, in the U.S. with grinding and hustling and kind of just bettering our lot in life. We like to understand, you know, bringing knowledge from places that I visit to what we're all doing in the U.S. Anyway, I'm standing in front of the Pyramid of the Sun. I'll do a little spin around. Gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Definitely dope. It's only 9:30. We came out here super, super early. We actually got to catch the moon and a little bit of the sun. We didn't get the full sunrise, but we got like some of the moon. Loving it here. The decision is always first to book the ticket, but once you book that ticket, you never regret it. It's the hardest decision to make, I know, but just book the freaking ticket.
History.
I know.
We got a whole history lesson this morning.
And Victor, our tour guide.
Victor was awesome.
Good. Very,
very,
very
good.
Good
job.
Yeah. So if you come, I recommend you pay the couple hundred pesos to get the
absolutely
the tour.
And be careful with catching your breath.
Oh my God, the altitude.
It's a little bit hard to breathe.
Yeah. It wasn't too bad though. Definitely doable. So.
Yeah.
Anyway. Welcome.
We're not discussing. Look, I did not sign up for this. My uncle used to have all these these things on his bucket list. And now he's acting like, oh well, this is life, I guess not. That listen, man, you can still do what you wanna do. You gotta trust that. Heard once that in God times when you need a sign, that's when they appear. Yes, since my text message didn't resonate, I just say it here. Hate the fact my mom cooped up in her apartment, telling herself that she's too sick to get dressed up and go do shit. Like that's true shit. All my family from the M town that I've been around start treating me like I'm him now. Like we don't know each other, we ain't grow together, we just friends now. Shit got me feeling pinned down. Pick the pen up and put the pen down. Writing to you from a distance like a pen pal, but we've been down.
Don't think about damn. Too much. There's no need for us to rush this through. Give up.